Good day. My name is Musa Dube from holinessadvocate.com. How I wish this would be brief. I'll try to be as brief as I possibly can. But just before I go to my lesson today, I just want to say that we choose in this world. It's a life of choice. We choose what we want to be known for. Some people choose to be known for entertainment. They do comedy, they sing. Others choose to be players, even if they are, some people you know is interesting, even if they are good players. For example, a good soccer player would just choose not to be known for that. We choose what we want to be known for. I chose to be known for holiness, advocating for holiness. It's my choice. I could choose to be known for anything else, for something else. Well, I do know that some people would can know me for evangelizing. I do that too. But I just chose to be publicly known and much, much known for advocating for holiness. Why? Because holiness is a condition set out in the Bible for people that want to inherit heaven. That's what I want to achieve at the end of my life. I have not achieved it yet, and I'm pursuing holiness the best way I can, as guided by the Bible. But my point is, without holiness, no man shall see God. And that condition, or that is a condition that doesn't change, is the truth. Even if I don't declare it or nobody does, but it doesn't change the truth. Denying the truth doesn't change the truth. I therefore want to encourage you that whatever you learn that comes from the Bible, practice it, because it is not by man, it is by God, and it doesn't change. God is known for not changing his standards. When you go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 11, verse 1, we get to learn that God detests imbalanced scales. It is an abomination to God to use imbalanced scales. If you go to Proverbs chapter 16, verse 11, a similar verse says that it is God who sets fairness. Again, the same phrase, imbalanced scales are an abomination to God, appear again. I therefore would want to encourage you in whichever area of influence. If you are a pastor, if you are a leader, maybe a high position politician, or you are a manager, make sure that you balance your scales, because if those scales are imbalanced, God detests that. It is an abomination to God. For example, if you have to reward people for good performance, make sure that you make all efforts within your means to identify good performers and go and give similar rewards to all of them. If you are a father, make sure that your children get equal benefits. If you buy one thing for one of them, for whatever reason, make sure you balance that across all your children. Even if you don't stay with your child, make sure that your child, without knowing it, gets equal benefits from the same father, which is yourself, like every other of your children. I just want to encourage you to take note of that, because as we live in life, those things may be maybe ignored. You may think you are using your discretion as a leader, but I'm just bringing it up today so that you are aware that God also looks at those things. Be blessed. Keep well.